My name is Cesar Navarrete. I am an RCC student and my degree is in mechanical engineering and I am from Medford, Oregon.
I'm Landon Hunter, a mechanical engineering major at RCC and Ashland, Oregon.
Can I ask you, how did you get into Invent Oregon? Cesar, I'll start with you.
In the beginning of the term, my physics teacher was telling us about the engineering club to join, and that's when he told us about the Invent Oregon. And that every year it's done. And I was like, yeah, let's try this.
Landon, this is at least your second year at Invent Oregon. How does it feel to be back here again? And what brought you back?
Engineering club, essentially. Every year we try to send a team out. And I was interested in not doing a one person. I didn't really have any great ideas. So I figured if anyone else in the club comes forward with a good idea, I'd join as more of a secondary team member instead of the main ideas person running everything, as it was very stressful to be a one-man team last year.
So Cesar, it sounds like you're spearheading this project. What kind of impact Dusty had on the development of ExoHand and getting you into Invent Oregon? What kind of impact did he have?
He is the one who introduced me to Invent Oregon. He explained what the project was, and then he gave us an example. And then he asked us if we had any idea, it could be anything, to put it out there and we can see how it goes and work it out. And I think it was until the second week of our meetings where I told him, you know what, I've had an idea for quite a while. And then I pitched it to him. He goes, yeah, you can work on it. You can do it. If you feel like you can, let's do it.
Did Dusty help you gain the confidence that you felt like you needed in order to compete?
Yeah, because he keeps telling me you can do it. And that means a lot to me.
That's amazing. It's nice to have someone who is there backing you and supporting you and helping you do these things because they're hard. Landon, you've known Dusty for a while. You've been involved with him. You know, he has helped you out last year. Have you seen anything on your end that he has done that has been especially impactful for ExoHand?
Well, so far, we're still relatively early in the development. So his biggest contribution is mostly just convincing us that we can try for it, to be honest.
No, that's perfect. That's I definitely don't mean to understate the importance of that because that's the first step for everyone. So let's talk a little bit about ExoHand. Cesar, what is ExoHand?
It's basically an exoskeleton that you put behind your hand to act as a support system. What I thought to make it move would be pneumatic cylinders. At first, I thought of using a hydraulic system, but it seemed like it was going to be messy with the oil, and to get something that small to put on your hand wasn't going to be feasible. I decided to go with pneumatics, and that's where I'm at right now.
Can you describe to me what it looks like and how it would work?
I'm actually using the pneumatic can as a holder to hold my phone up right now. Well, here, I got some bits that I have. It's going to be something where you latch onto the back of your hand, and it'll be some actuators that we put it in between, and also on the back of your hand where it's another clip that sits on here. And they'll both try and get it on the camera. They'll both be pushing each other. Use the force of it to close your hand. And that's as far as I got so far right now.
Great. Where did you get the inspiration for this idea?
A couple years back, I used to work in irrigation and as a plumber. After years of doing that, I was having issues gripping stuff and also holding certain amount of weights with my hands. And my wife was commenting, he goes, what are you going to do when you get older? And I was like, you know what, I'll just build something to help me out. And that's where the idea came from.
Can you talk a little bit more about why did you lose your grip strength? Do you have an idea of why that happened?
Carpal tunnel. I went to the doctor and they told me about it and they prescribed me some lotion to numb the pain away. My whole issue was the strength. The pain I can manage. Losing the strength was affecting my work. And so I needed to find some solution for that.
Carpal tunnel is a huge issue. I'm sure you're aware of that. Do you have an idea of who you think you will help by inventing this?
There's different types of illnesses that affect your strength in your hands. And also, I've noticed that a lot of the solutions for repairing that is surgeries. And not a lot of people have that amount of money to do the surgeries or health insurance to cover that amount. So it'd be something they can use for the meanwhile, especially if they're trying to work still and use their hands.
I have a non-carpal tunnel example. I had an injury when I was a kid that, particularly along the side of my wrist, just basically sliced it out, including a good portion of the nerves in my left hand. I don't have this quite the same level of grip strength issue, but where I can't use it that much. But if I did use it professionally, something like this would be really useful for me. Because my feeling all the way along this part of my hand, index finger and thumb, is mostly gone. So something like this would be really useful if I were working in an environment where I was gripping with my left hand a lot.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm wondering if either of you envision ExoHand as also being something that could be preventative as opposed to reactive, in the sense that people who are working in jobs that require a lot from their wrists and their hands could benefit by having this before the problem starts. Is that true?
Yes, I believe it could, because like I said, I want it to be of a support system. Theoretically, I want it to the point where touch sensitive, where all you have to do is apply a little bit of pressure between your fingers and it'll move according to that.
I'm not going to lie, I'm having visions of some sort of superhero movie where they're using a device like this to grip something really strong. Is that something that could be done?
Yes, I have thought about that, to where you, like, work ethic wise as mechanics, instead of having to reach out for a wrench, you could use your hand, like, literally grip the bolt, increase the strength and unscrew it, use your arm as leverage and take the bolt off and unscrew it, and stuff where you need to crimp down what, like, wires, if you need to crimp them down to put the adapters on them, just use your hands. And also, I had thoughts about applying that as to your limbs, to where you're able to run as fast as a vehicle or jump like the Hulk. Would be pretty cool.
That would be amazing. Sign me up. I would love to play around with that. How much force does this hand potentially actually generate?
Well, from the pneumatics I researched, the max amount I can put on each cylinder is about 0.8 megapascals, which is roughly around 160 psi. So that's quite a bit. If anything, I need to find how to reinforce the clips.
Yeah, a big part of the limitation is really going to be mounting to the hand itself. One of the big challenges is that you either have to some degree, you go relatively light on the amount of reinforcement you're going with, because you're going to be gripping directly with the hand, or you have to essentially have it be more heavy duty, where it has to be very custom fitted to a person, where you actually have the point of contact being fully the exoskeleton, so your hand doesn't take the load. I wouldn't be surprised if we need to branch the project two different directions for a higher and lower yield version. One for like a more daily use, if someone everyday problems gripping things, and one for a more heavy duty use for something like an industrial workplace.
Landon, I'm glad you brought up some of the challenges, because I have a couple questions. First, can you help me 160 PSI in context?
Part of the challenge is converting this into real grip strength. We have the actual amount of force that a single cylinder can provide, but we also have to consider how long the hand is and how long the fingers are. And, well, how do I put this? Basically, the limitation is really going to less be the cylinders, because the cylinders can put a pretty enormous amount of force out. But the real limitation is going to be how well get it integrated with the hand.
Let's talk a little bit about more some of the problems you expect to confront. Cesar, is this your first entrepreneurship challenge?
Yes.
You're going to be going through a program that's going to help you develop your idea and pitch to investors. What are some of the biggest challenges that you see going through Invent Oregon? And these could be challenges with the business itself. They could also be challenges with being a first-time entrepreneur and being exposed to this environment for the first time.
Well, I previously went to the Zoom boot camp. That was this weekend, and that one kind of took me back, because it started talking more about the user and the customer, how it's going to be applied to them, how it's going to be marketed. All this was new, and it was something I never thought about. I figured I'd have someone else just think about that and get it out there, and I'll just invent. No, it's a two-man team right here. We got to do all of it together. I take a step back to look at it from that angle, instead of just looking at it through the inventor.
Landon, I'll ask you, because you are returning to Invent Oregon for the second time, what do you see, having been through the program already, as being challenges that you expect ExoHand to face during the course of competition?
One of the big challenges is that, unlike the previous project I went with, where the Invent Oregon prototype could be one or two steps removed from a final product, the final product for this type of thing is going to be relatively challenging to manufacture compared to a prototype. And optimizing a lot of the challenges, like power supply issues, are going to be really, really important and also very challenging, just because it's a device that's actually designed to be worn. With a lot of early development prototypes, you can kind of get away with the device being a little larger, especially with electronics. Like, I know Arduinos are a really typical prototyping tool, but if you're wearing a device, you don't really want to have an Arduino strapped to your arm with a bunch of electronics. You really want to have something well, you know, well engineered to be small, compact, and wearable. So we're going to have to spend a lot more time thinking about the direct user experience, because we're going to have to optimize a lot more to get things to be properly wearable compared to a normal prototype that's, you know, not designed to be worn.
That's great. Thanks for your answer. I also kind of want to dream just a little bit, because this is a really cool idea. Do you imagine extending this to something, to a bigger application or a broader application where maybe it's not just a hand, but you're also integrating this into something a bit larger, like a full arm? Or I'm starting to let my imagination go wild here. What do you kind of see as being a trajectory that you can take this?
Well, I do see it going something like that, to where you apply it to all your limbs, be an enhancement instead of just as a support. Mm-hmm. Just a wild thought. It could be given out to the military, to where it can be used to help soldiers. I know that in the military, they'll have Jeeps all compact where they can them individually take them apart. But if you have soldiers that aren't that physically strong to be able to take that apart, that can help them. Or to be able to carry a wounded soldier out of the battlefield, that would help them, where strength is needed.
Yeah, one thing I'd bring up generally, partially because I think prosthetics are an area of engineering I'm really interested in. There's a lot of opportunity once you start expanding out of just a hand. And a lot of that really comes down to is that everything has to be essentially braced on something else. So when you're working with a hand, you're kind of limited to just empowering grip strength, because, you know, at the end of the day, your arm still has to hold it up. But one of the really cool parts about expanding to, let's say, a full arm is that it kind of becomes more of a full body system, where your arm itself, even without a powered system, can be passively held up by something that's attached to the core of your body. You know, despite this seeming very sci-fi and high-tech, even a system that's completely unpowered can still be an enormous increase in functional strength for the user.
Adding on to what Landon said about having a full arm, you can also extend it down to your waist, to your leg, to where it supports its own self.
Yeah, to some degree, it's kind of, you have a fully fleshed out system. It's a lot less like you're wearing something and a lot more like you're inside something, if that makes sense.
Let's talk a little about the competition. Let's think about it from the other side. Looking back, past the finals, you've presented and pitched and hopefully have placed really well. What do you hope to get out of your experience at Invent Oregon? I'll start with you, Cesar.
The knowledge on how all this works, because I literally didn't know nothing about this. I didn't know about the program. I didn't know what it entitled. So all this is new, and it's knowledge I'm obtaining and I'm happy about. And it's also experience that I'm gaining. So when I get out of it, I can be like, you know what, I was in this program and I did all this and I learned this. So I have experience in all of this, and it'll be good on my resume and also to have.
And Landon, right. I'll ask you, coming back for a second year, what do you hope to gain this time around?
This shouldn't be that much of a surprise, but for anyone who watched the finals last year, but I was kind of disappointed with how everything turned out to some degree. I'm very happy with the work that I put in and the final product that I put out, but I kind of came to realize that I can't take on a highly multidisciplinary project as a single person. And because of that, I was a little bit disappointed with how the final outcome came out. So I'm really excited to be working on a team where I can actually bounce ideas off someone else and have someone else to work with for such an ambitious project, compared to the 3 sleepless months of, you know, working really hard on my own.
Yeah, I can imagine that it would be a lot for one person to take on. And I'm glad that you have a partner also. So one last final question for the both of you. What is the most important thing that you want the judges to know about ExoHand?
That it can be used by anybody.
That's great. Anything to add, Landon?
No, I think that pretty much covers that. Instead of seeing it as just a device for people that have specifically grip issues, it'd be nice to really show people that this can be a powerful general use device.
That's amazing, guys. So that wraps it up for me on my end. Thanks again so much for taking the time. It was great to talk to you and hear about this invention. I'm really psyched about the different applications that you might be able to get out of it, and hope that I can demo it one day when we have the prototype ready to go.